Hello, my name is Creostix, and welcome to Mass Effect Andromeda. And I am a huge fan of the original trilogy, and, well, you know, yeah, the third game was, you know, a little whatever. There is that. The ending was bad, and it was the game itself wasn't quite up to par with the other two. I still had fun playing it, with the exception of the ending. I'm a fan of the trilogy, even though the end was a little, yeah. So, I actually tried playing this earlier a bit, and then the recording got borked, and I don't actually know, do I need to make my character again? Yes, I do. Interesting. Okay, well, at least now I have an idea of how this character creator sort of works, so let's see if we can get through this in a fairly quick fashion. So let's see, I think I liked, yeah, this head type, but we're far from done. Just a couple of things here. That's actually, brow height was a little, let's do it this way, let's be all slightly frowny. Yes, 5. Yeah, that's about okay. Couple of tiny adjustments here and there. There we are. Right. Chin. I usually don't make very, extreme characters. I feel like I need to look at those faces for quite some time, so I figure I might as well try to make something that's, you know, something I can look at. So there's that. That's fine. I believe that's more or less okay as well. Bit of width, a bit of let's see, less depth. Yeah, that's fine. The mouth is whatever. That's okay. The nose size is maybe a tiny bit big. There we go. There, and nose depth. Sure. That's fine. Nose height. Let's put it, yeah, about there. Good. Okay, then, hairstyle. And here's where we don't have a whole bunch of options. This is quite the look there. But they're all like, there's still no super long-haired metal dude, which is, I get it, they're kinda like almost military most of the time, so I guess. But then again, they do have this, which is in the ballpark of something semi-long, and also that, and this. So why not a long-haired metal dude? Maybe the problem is that long hair is notoriously difficult to animate correctly. Or, well, because I actually saw a little bit of gameplay earlier of someone playing a female character with a ponytail hair, and it looked weird. It looked sort of floaty in the bad way, you know? But from these options, I feel like it's gonna be either, well, that's actually surprisingly not terrible if you want a long-haired dude, but I kind of like the blast back even a little more. I think that's called a blast back. Something in the ballpark of a blast pack, yes. Okay, hair color, we're going to go dark, yes, because not an edgelord, but a bit of a metal dude anyway, so let's have that. Actually, why is the hair color, I pressed B, didn't I? Fuck, okay, give me a hot second. And hairstyle, let's go back and put, was it 5? Yes, 5. Good. I don't probably need sideburns, but I believe, let's go through this real quick. There's the option of nothing, the option of a porn stash, the option of a porn stash with sideburns, the option of actually kinda okay beard. I can't remember who I've seen who has this, but I think a celebrity or two has something around this area. Not sure. This is pretty okay. It's like a, you know, low chaos kind of a small beard. A big beard with stash, sideburns. Big porn stash with a beard, and that's that. I tend to go usually with the small beard type. It gives a bit of personality, but it I always press B, goddammit. There. It gives a bit of personality, but it doesn't go overboard, which is good. Yeah. And then the security options, which would be during your training options, and then the first one is security. During your Alliance military service, you focused on learning everything you could about weapons and tactics. Starting power, concussive shot. Fires a heat-seeking, high-impact round to knock down opponents. Unlocked skills, turbocharge. Grants a massive short-term boost to weapon fire rate and thermal clip efficiency. Combat fitness grants increased durability and the option to carry more weapons into battle. That's actually pretty useful. Biotic. You were effectively designated biotic during your Alliance military tenure, assisting your cohorts with your ability to control mass effect fields. Starting power, throw. Use your biotic powers to hurl an opponent through the air. Unlock skills. Singularity. Create a vortex that will trap and disable enemies caught in its field. Barrier. Bolster your defenses with a powerful biotic barrier. Ooh. I rarely play biotics, but it's still pretty interesting. Oops. Technician. As a technician in the Systems Alliance military, you learn to operate drones and hack enemy systems. Starting power, overload. Unleash an electrostatic discharge that deals high damage to shields and synthetic enemies. Can chain to multiple targets. Unlocked skills, invasion. Hack into your opponent's armor and weapons, infecting them with a computer virus to weaken their defenses and even spread to nearby foes. Team support. Develop specialized technology to bolster the survivability of your entire squad. Leader. You were a team player and a natural leader in the Alliance military, working closely with your cohorts for their safety and the safety of others. Starting power, energy drain. Drain your target's shields to replenish your own. Especially effective against synthetic enemies. Unlock skills, annihilation. Weave a shifting aura of mass effect fields around you to slowly damage nearby foes. Team support. Develop specialized technology to bolster the survivability of your entire squad, the same as before, I believe. Scrapper. Sorry. When a fight broke out, you were always the first soldier in the thick of it, mostly according to Alliance military protocol, and occasionally not. Starting power, charge. Launch yourself like a comet at opponents and regain a portion of your shields on impact. Unlocked skills. Combat fitness. Grants increased durability and the option to carry more weapons into battle. Charge. See above. So it's like a better charge, I believe. And then, operative. In the Alliance military, you studied covert operations and the tech used by special forces knowledge you rarely found use for until the Andromeda Initiative. Starting power, tactical cloak. Employ light-bending technology to become invisible for a short duration. Gain a large damage bonus when you break cloak to attack. Unlock skills. Combat fitness. Grants increased durability and the option to carry more weapons into battle and tactical cloak see above. So I think what speaks to me most is the security, the leader, and the operative. And I kind of like the idea of the operative to have the ability to cloak away from difficult spots. I've heard it's not as easy as the other Mass Effects, which actually I think could be good. That speaks to me that maybe even in the normal difficulty, it would have some weight to the battles, which sounds very, very nice. And yeah, if you're wondering about the super weird text on the sides of my keyboard here, the kohdistin vasen and all that, I had to change my language to correspond to my area because just technology is weird, man. I had to do that. So yeah, I'm from Finland. If I haven't told that already. And I feel like the Twin, which is not the character I'm playing as, is, I don't want to fiddle around with it because I got this feeling that I want to go with the creator's intent there. So Might as well go there. I had a male shepherd when I played, so there's that, which... I hear actually that most people like playing the female shepherd, which sounds awesome. That's pretty cool, man. And here we go. I believe now is a good time to start the game with a male operative and Creostix Ryder, because that is, yes, very rolls off the tongue like poetry. Yes, good. And the difficulty, I think I'm gonna go with normal to have intended for players with experience playing shooters and RPGs. I have some of that. And it's the baseline Mass Effect combat experience, so it's the intended experience. So let's roll with that. Yes, let's start the game. Yes. And yep, exporting the appearance data. So, yeah. I actually, speaking of the original trilogy, I'm one of the few people who, at least when it was a couple of years old when I played the first game, I'm one of those people of the minority who didn't have a big problem with the Mako. It controlled a little odd, but I got the hang of it pretty quickly. The one thing that took some adjusting was the cannon, which wouldn't shoot straight into what you were aiming at if you were tilted, but that's about it. EA presents, apparently, a BioWare production. And that's the important part.
Every great moment in our history began with a dream.
I will believe you on that. I choose to.
Each bold leap forward was achieved by those willing to do anything to attain it.
Sounds legit, sure.
We are, all of us, leaving behind families, homes, the very birthplace of our species.
To have a journey
for discovery, to see the unknown, others for a new start.
Others for a new Mass Effect game, yes.
But today, whatever our reasons, we take the first steps toward a new future for humanity.
That is, away from Mass Effect
today,
3.
We begin to make our dream reality.
Which will end up with a lot of death and combat and everything shit hitting the fan everywhere because it's a Mass Effect game. Oh well, I kinda like that. There wouldn't be a game otherwise, you know? In the year 2185, humanity lives in a golden era of interstellar travel. Our discovery of ancient alien ruins on Mars propelled our understanding of science and technology ahead by thousands of years. While many now enjoy the newfound freedom and challenges of exploration in the Milky Way, others look to even more distant stars. For the 100,000 adventurers embarking on this one-way voyage, the future begins in Andromeda. Mass Effect. I'm excited. I'm super excited. I've heard some people say that the faces are a bit weird in these, but I don't know. My character looks fine to me, but then again, well, 634 years later, date 0 hour, 0 day. And that ship design looks pretty cool, man. I like it. Lots of lights going on, and it has an aesthetic look of... I kinda enjoy that. Ark Hyperion occupies the 20,000 human colonists. I'm blanking on what the Normandy's engine called. I wonder if that's the same kind of one. Andromeda Galaxy, destination Habitat 7 in Helios Cluster. Sounds... Habitat 7, Hyperion cryogenics. So we've been in cryo sleep? Rough guess? I would have to imagine so, yeah. Hi, me. I'm looking awesome. A bit wrinkly, but that's fine. Well, do you know that?
Deep breaths. You're gonna want to take it easy.
I'm always
taking it easy for 600 years.
years.
And there's that too, yeah.
Ryder, recon specialist, Pathfinder mission team.
Pathfinder team, eh? The ones finding us a home.
Mm. Can you make it somewhere tropical? Nice, warm ocean, summer year-round?
How about we get him a cup of coffee first?
We'll see. The male helper or doctor or something reminds me of some character in Mass Effect, but I can't place it. Sure. Hi, Asari.
Ryder,
Lexi.
Let's get you checked out.
Let's.
Look here.
After discovering an unusually high ratio of potential candidates for...
Why are you on a human arc? I'm not judging.
Wave of arcs arriving in Andromeda, our new home for humanity.
Is everything cool?
Makes it sound so easy, doesn't it?
Tone choice. Emotional, logical, casual, and professional. I can already say that I'm gonna keep mixing up casual and professional icons. That could be a little... I don't know. Yeah, sure.
Even if it isn't, we'll be ready.
We've been waiting...
I hope so.
We'll be fine.
Word came down. The Pathfinder wants you all mission ready within the hour. Look this way.
Why
sure.
He didn't say. But something's up.
Okay.
Okay, everything checks out. Just one more thing before I send you on your way. Let's
sure.
test your SAM implant.
Sam?
Sam, are you monitoring?
Is it a missile thing?
Sam, are you online?
Yes, Dr. Tapero. Good morning, Ryder. Are you feeling well?
I'm awesome. Yeah. My implant?
I just need a second to get my bearings. What's this about my implant?
A routine check. After being in stasis, we want to make sure the connection's still live.
Okay.
As the team's mission computer, your well-being is my primary concern.
Assuming the implants work as advertised, Sam sees what you see, in theory. We won't know for sure until we get you in the field. How are you feeling, otherwise?
I'm super excited, yes.
I'm ready to get to it.
Readings confirmed. I detect an increased level of adrenaline in your system. The neural implant is functioning properly.
Caffeine always did make me jumpy.
You're all done. Let's get you on your way.
Though let's,
you may
absolutely.
Want to hang around while we revive your sister,
oh, yeah.
It helps to see a familiar face.
I don't like the sound of that.
Oh, bad. Are the collectors coming? Oh. A space seaweed? Great. Oh, you could have dodged, but I mean the seaweed. Oh, okay. Didn't no one see that, like, coming?
Just hang on.
I'm looking around like a champ, and that dude is having an awesome time, flipping vaults all the way. Keep on doing that. It'll get better all the. We're holding on. Yes. Cora.
Brace for a reset.
Reset. Do we?
Everyone okay?
I'm awesome.
I think so.
What happened?
We're not sure. Sensors are scrambled. But it's good to see you're up. Feels like centuries since we spoke.
This is the Pathfinder. Mission teams continue preparations. Cora, Riders, report to the bridge.
You heard him. Let's get.
We have a problem over here.
Oh?
It's Sarah Ryder.
Oh. No, the sister I've never met before, or will have, but me, I haven't, but you know. Is everything, you know? And if you're wondering why I'm being quiet when they're talking, I feel like it's the correct way to let them speak and, you know, let you hear what they're saying as much as possible. I try to avoid talking over them. Okay. Tell me.
Ryder.
Hi.
Is my sister okay?
Yeah.
Sarah's fine. Her vitals are strong, but the revival procedure was interrupted.
What's the prognosis?
When can she wake up?
We don't want to rush it. Sam?
My connection to Sarah's implant was suspended. However, her pulse, respiration, and brain activity are all normal.
Good.
To be on the safe side, we'll need to keep her in a low-level coma for a while, then let her body regain consciousness naturally. She'll be fine.
Glad to hear it.
Thanks, Lexi. Keep us updated.
Well, that's
Ryder,
great.
I'll wait for you at the door, whenever you're ready to go.
So that sounds good. Can I talk to you again?
Don't worry, Ryder. We'll take care of her. She'll make it.
Okay. I can't talk to you. Can I... Information wall haze. Hello?
It sounds amazing, doesn't it? Right up until you lose gravity.
Ah, don't be a killjoy. Zero G is fun. Information wall.
Hi there. I'm the
Andromeda,
founder of the Andromeda Initiative.
Hello.
I'm here to welcome you to a whole new galaxy. The good news is, the hard part's over.
I beg to differ.
If you have any questions now, just ask.
It's a Mass Effect game. The hard part is not over.
The selection process saw the Andromeda Initiative evaluate thousands of potential habitable planets within the galaxy.
And now we're here.
Mm-hmm. You are a part of the first wave of arcs arriving in Andromeda, our new home for humanity.
Okay.
Once the Pathfinder team's assessment is complete, Habitat 7 has been selected as the most likely candidate for colonization.
Sure. What about the other arcs?
Your current location is Arc Hyperion, housing the human population. Arc Parchero, the Solarian vessel, confirmed departure in 2185.
Okay. Solarian, Asari, and Turian arcs. Okay. I still ask a bit... Well, I mean, I don't have anything against Asari being here, the doctor. Maybe she's an such an awesome doctor that she got here, which sounds good, yeah.
Responsible for exploring and assessing new worlds for outpost placement and settlement.
Okay.
Is led by a Pathfinder who represents their species.
And that's my dad. Damn straight.
Duty roster shows you are assigned to the Pathfinder mission team, Specialist Ryder.
Sure. Andromeda Initiative.
The Andromeda Initiative encompasses all colonization efforts, including arcs, pathfinders, outposts, and the central support hub, the Nexus.
Mm-hmm.
The current location of the Nexus is unknown.
Oh.
Status of outposts are unknown.
Oh. Is that good? Well, it's probably not good.
I'm Gian Garson.
Hi. Love and friendship?
With a vision of a better future.
Oh.
A vision that you shape. Life
sure.
In Andromeda can be anything we dare to dream. And I'm proud to help make those dreams come true. Drop me a note sometime. I'd love to hear how we're doing.
How can I drop you a note? Mission status.
At present, Arc Hyperion has arrived in the Helios cluster. Further mission updates are offline due to technical difficulties.
Aw. I'm on my way. Give me a hot second. Well, and I love exploring this the environments and hearing most of the
Still in stasis. Vitals look good.
Okay. And yeah, and I love hearing all of the dialogues and such.
This one's still asleep. Weird.
Does it help me somehow if I check on the cryopods? Sure. Apparently there's nothing here, which I would have loved. I don't know, a data pad or something. Oh, and I think there's a... Let's see, is there a zoom button? Is there a run button? Oh, right. Hit the LS stick. Okay, good. Data pad. So... I feel like there's going to be a lot of data pads, and unless it's going to be super important, I'm not going to read all of them. It would take forever. I'm fine with reading stuff, but I feel like you're not probably interested in.
Hey there. Hell of a wake up call, huh? Didn't expect that first thing out of stasis.
Yeah, sure.
Makes two of us. Hang in there.
But yeah, if you want me to read all of these, just. Tell me in the comments and I'll oblige, sure, but I feel like it's probably more entertaining to just, you know, not read them all out loud. It would take a long time. Fisher, are you...
Morning, Ryder. Or afternoon? Or... I don't know.
Afternoon is fine, yeah. Are you Sam Fisher of Splinter Cell? Are you gonna sneak some shit? Yes. Kirkland.
Good to see you, Ryder. Sorry, still waiting for some coffee.
Sure. Okay, good. Can I talk to you? I forgot your name already. Cora. Cora. Right. Cora. Good. Okay. I think. I am always ready. Oh. Oh, shit. Malfunction. Investigate. Look. Hi. Hello.
Whatever hit the arc fried everything. We have to balance the power loader or it can explode.
Oh, no. Everywhere.
Ryder could find it. He has a scanner. Quick, Ryder, use it to locate the vault.
I have a scanner.
I'll try to get readings on the second conduit.
Ooh.
There's no indication of a fault in this component.
Axial coupling.
Relay 2C shows damage from a temperature spike.
Okay.
Found it. Bad relay.
Good.
Ryder, can you go reset it?
There we go.
There. It's reset.
Good. I saved the world? Question mark? Oh no. Okay, good. Well, that's actually so we have this Metroid Prime scanner thing, which sounds interesting, and I got a feeling I shouldn't probably read everything that says either. It would also take a long time, but well, we'll see. But let's open the door and hello everyone. Anything to scan?
That was close. Barely an Andromeda, and we're already scrambling.
Oh, it's fun.
The adventure begins.
Datapad, sure.
Begins.
Not sure your dad will see it that way.
Oh, dad is fun. You just need to get to know him. Let's go to the bridge, sure. But yeah, if you want me to read everything I can, but I feel like it's probably better if I don't. It would be very slow, you see. It's gonna be a slow game anyway, so I got a feeling it's probably better this way. I hope. Let me know though. I'll listen to feedback. Absolutely.
Helm control, report. We're drifting. Flight controls aren't responding.
Does it help if you run around the
first
cockpit?
First priority is stopping these outages.
Mainline power's been knocked out. We're on reserves, Captain.
It looks like an oil painting, kinda. That's weird.
What's our position?
Unknown. We lost telemetry.
Sam.
Dad?
We need eyes out there.
Attempting to adjust.
He does look like me. Huh, interesting.
Alec, please. You may be Pathfinder, but this is my ship.
Captain, the protocol's clear. In the absence of communication with the Nexus or the other arcs, we proceed to our appointed golden world. Solid ground.
If it's even out there. Nobody said anything about running into an energy cloud. And that's just a wild guess what we hit.
Right, but you... If you have a protocol for such a thing, then...
Alec, I need to assess the damage. Stop the bleeding. We've got 20,000 people asleep on this ship. Let's give them a chance to wake up.
Can you blame her?
I'm with Dad.
My father's got a point, though.
Yeah.
Solid ground sounding pretty good right now.
Yeah, but...
Pretty good. Isn't good enough.
Yes, sir.
Stern father, yes.
We're coming through.
Are we?
My God.
Do you have one?
Is that our golden world?
That's Habitat 7. New Earth.
I don't have one, I mean. Whatever. I mean, a god. But sure.
All of our long-range scans told us it was in the green zone. Perfect for human settlement.
And now it's a swamp world.
It doesn't even look the same.
We can't give up.
We don't know how bad it is yet. Still seems like it's our best shot.
Maybe. There's just a lot on the line.
Sam?
The energy from the phenomenon is damping our senses. Planetary conditions are unknown.
Oh. I think it's a swamp world of more.
20,000 souls adrift at sea. And when the power runs out and stays out, we need to know if that's safe harbor.
And if it's not,
then we kill everything in
as
there.
As Pathfinder, it'll be my job to find an alternative. It's what we trained for. But if this goes well,
we'll all have candy.
We're already home.
I have my doubts, but sure.
All right, just make it quick.
Harper, the rest of the team should be awake by now. Have them spin up two shuttles. Planet Fallen 30.
Right.
Yes, sir.
A stubborn one, isn't he?
You need to just give him a chance. He's fun, I'm sure.
He cares in his own way. Enough to give him a chance.
I suppose you're right. He is our Pathfinder. If this doesn't work out, we'll need him more than ever.
I need an ETA on our sensor repairs. We're blind out here.
You should probably get on that. I'd love to know what's on the planet before I go there, but, you know, that's... Can't have everything, I suppose. Ah, a loading screen. Hi.
My sister's gonna hate that she missed this.
Are all the Riders adrenaline junkies?
I guess it's in her blood. She beat me into the world by 1 minute.
Oh.
Couldn't wait to get started.
Well, don't worry. I'm sure Sarah will pull through.
When she does, she's gonna want stories.
So, let's get out there and find her some.
Sure, let's do that.
Right. You'll want to get your helmet. And maybe stop at the good luck rock before we go.
The what?
It's an old superstition of your dad's.
What's the good luck rock? And where? Datapad. Team field manual. Yeah. First contact protocol. Shoot first, ask questions later. Yeah. Probably not, but you know.
Better not. No bathroom breaks in this trip.
Okay. Oh, I can scan it. Liquid water is present. Its structure is a water dispenser. Oh!
Analysis indicates alkali feldspar and quartz, commonly known as granite.
A granite rock.
Good luck rock, huh?
Dad was mountain climbing back on Earth. It caught him from falling. The way things are going today, we'll need any luck we can get.
And he alone just carried it home then. Sure. I don't want to turn off their music, I think. Hi, guys.
Hey, Ryder.
Hi.
It's Kirkland, right? Yeah. I think we met just before the Hyperion left Earth.
And in the sick bay or whatever.
Hi there. Your dad say anything about what's going on?
We don't know.
Tough to say. Sensors can't get a read on the planet.
Well, at least it keeps things interesting.
Damn straight.
Yeah. It's a shame to go through all this training and not put it to good use.
I think you're gonna...
See you guys in the ride down.
You're gonna get some use, I feel like. Helmet. Thank you.
The Pathfinder is now requiring sidearms. I've opened the armaments locker.
We expecting trouble, Sam?
A precaution. Please arm yourself, Ryder.
Sure.
Hope I won't need this.
I got a feeling you're gonna need it a lot. Did I read this one yet? I think that's new. Okay, good. Do they go to the codex or some such? Are we good?
So just another boring day at the office, huh?
Yep, I can't wait. I've waited for
a
long time.
This wouldn't be any fun. I can't wait to find out what's down there.
I know what you mean.
I feel like
we
do.
I always wondered what it was like when explorers crossed the ocean. Nothing but stars and dead reckoning to guide them.
And a map that said, here be dragons.
Well, if they made it, we can too. And maybe see a dragon along the way.
Because BioWare made Dragon Age, you see, yes. Let's hope.
Never know. Let's keep an eye out.
And our distance.
Be fun.
On that note, time to get to the shuttle.
Right. Open door. Sounds good, yes. And another bit of a loading screen. That's great. The animation is actually kind of okay on that. I sure. Oh, hi. You're
Dr. Carlyle.
Packing coffee?
With everything going on, I think the Ark needs you more than we do.
I agree.
Pathfinder wants a medic on hand, and if that is home down there, I'm happy to knock on the door.
It could get rough, though.
Yeah, we're just not sure what's on the other side of the door.
No problem. If it has teeth, I brought the pliers. Yank them out myself.
You might be eating those.
We leave in five.
Sir,
okay.
We broke out the weapons as requested. Anything we should know about?
Death, yes.
Situation. We'll be short-handed with Sarah out.
Because Sarah is the Kung Fu master who didn't need weapons.
Your sister's strong. She'll make it.
We shouldn't worry. She's going to be awesome, I hope.
Sarah wouldn't want us to worry because of her.
You're right. The mission comes first. Though, I doubt your mother would have seen it that way. I promised her I'd get you two here safely.
Oh well. Well, we're here still.
Okay, team, listen up.
Listening.
I chose each of you for the Pathfinder team, not just because you're talented and passionate, but because you're dreamers, like me.
We sleep a lot.
We dream of exploring the unknown.
Oh.
Finding the edge of the map. And then discovering what lies beyond.
On the table, yes.
When people look back on this, and they will, they'll remember we didn't give up. That we kept dreaming.
For 600 years.
A few faltering steps in Andromeda were the beginning of everything they know.
Will.
We only get one chance to be first. So, let's go make history.
Sure. Let's hope we make loads of history and not die in the process already.
Been waiting 600 years for this.
I've been waiting, what's that now? Five-ish? When did Mass Effect 3 come again? Something like that.
Archive Period, this is Shuttle 1. Switching to manual guidance. Shuttle 2, taking your leave.
Good luck, Pathfinder team.
I'm enjoying this. I'm finding this fun. It's cool. A couple of the faces are a bit weird, but only a couple so far. To me.
Whatever it is, it stopped the Hyperion in its tracks.
It appears to be an unstable mass of dark energy.
Huh. It looks still a bit, I don't know. The outside looks a bit, I don't know the word, low res maybe, or, you know? Like an oil painting, you know, and pixelated, or... Oh, hello, shuttle, bye. But maybe it's supposed to, I don't,
Ryder, we didn't have a chance to meet back in the Milky Way. Name's Liam Costa, security and response specialist.
Hello.
Good to meet you, Liam.
Hard to believe we're finally doing this.
Sure beats reading the brochures.
Beginning our deceleration, planet's dead ahead.
Okay. Oh, right, and entry, oxygen burning and such. Yeah, okay. Atmosphere and entry.
It'll pass.
Will it?
The controls are fighting me.
Fight back. Ooh, that. Oh. It looks kind of like the interstellar world if you've seen the movie. It's not quite as white here, but still.
Stay on course to the landing zone.
Oxygen levels
up. Sure.
Is this the right planet? We had this all worked out.
Can you take shuttle two?
The mountains are floating.
Oh, that's interesting.
Look, port side.
It
has to be advanced engineering.
Hyperion, this is the Pathfinder. We've got evidence of an alien civilization.
Which means guns and fighting. Aww. Be fun. Is this girl... Oh, lightning, so... Grab my hand? Come on! Yes, well, that went super well. Yeah. I see that. Yeah.
Your jump jet is malfunctioning.
Great.
Get it working.
Approaching terminal velocity.
Oh, great. And then Ryder died, and that's the end of Mass Effect and that's not good. Your wrist computer will help because it has a glass repairing app to it. Sure, great. That's useful. Well, can we get up? Anything broken? Okay, good. Well, it's not that bad. We just have a bit of floating islands and lightning, but it looks kinda okay. Well, it doesn't, but could be worse. It's not a lava world, you know. Oh, hi.
Sam's offline. Comlink's trashed.
Liam, right.
I'm surprised we aren't too.
Any survivors?
Did the others make it? I don't know. It was all a blur. Shuttle split in two. This is like some nightmare.
Well, you just said you wanted to have a combat or whatever. Oh, don't be so judgmental. It's a storm home.
Looks like we're gonna find some high ground. See if anyone else is alive. Come on.
Okay. Well, let's cool mushrooms. Can I
Ryder, how's your survival training? I've seen my share of troubles. Nothing crazy.
Unknown plant.
Well, crazy just found us. Those rocks out there are floating.
Sure.
Terra incognita.
I'm actually super.
Some of these plants look like tentacles.
Oh, did I get research point? I did, I think. Okay, awesome. So keep this handy. Sure. That's pretty great. But now we've.
Those structures we saw on the way in. Who could survive in a place like this?
Everyone, we're awesome. Don't be a killjoy, man. Okay, but. As we've now touched down and we have a stopping point-ish, I am all out of time for this episode, but I will be continuing this later on. I'm having fun with this. It's kind of cool so far. I hope you've enjoyed this. If you have, please do drop a like or a comment or even subscribe or share if you want to. It would really, really help. And do please give feedback if you want me to read more of the text I see. I can do that if there's a demand for it. And thank you so much for watching, and I will see you again next time.